ABO incompatibility occurs when a pregnant woman and her baby have incompatible blood types, leading to an immune response. This condition primarily arises when the mother has type O blood, and the baby has either type A, B, or AB blood. There are four main blood groups. Type A has antigens on red cells and anti-B antibodies in the plasma. Type B has B antigens on red cells and anti-A antibodies in the plasma. Type AB has both A and B antigens on red cells, and no anti-A or anti-B antibodies in the plasma. Type O has no A or B antigens on red cells, but has both anti-A and anti-B antibodies in the plasma. Let's have a look at how ABO incompatibility occurs. If a mother with type O blood carries a fetus with type A, B, or AB blood, her immune system may produce anti-A or anti-B antibodies. These antibodies can cross the placenta and enter the fetal bloodstream. The antibodies may attack the fetal red blood cells, causing them to break down. Hemolysis releases bilirubin, which can build up and cause jaundice in the newborn. Symptoms in newborns include jaundice, which is the yellowing of the skin and eyes due to high bilirubin levels, anemia or low red blood cell count, hepatosplenomegaly or enlargement of the liver and spleen due to increased work to filter out the damaged red blood cells, and hydrops fetalis, where there is abnormal accumulation of fluid in the fetal compartments. The diagnosis involves testing the mother's and baby's blood types. Direct and indirect Coombs tests to detect antibodies attached to red blood cells or free-floating antibodies in the blood. The treatment includes phototherapy to treat jaundice by using light to break down bilirubin in the skin. Exchange transfusion. In severe cases, to replace the baby's damaged blood with fresh blood, to reduce bilirubin levels and replace red blood cells, and intravenous immunoglobulin. Prevention strategies include regular monitoring of pregnant women with type O blood. Early diagnosis and treatment can prevent severe complications. And that's all for this video. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more informative health content. Stay tuned for our next video,